is being played out on a global stage, and we're in a, caught in a tug of war between two countries that hate each other and haven't spoken for 30 years. But we actually had lives before this, and you know, God willing, I have faith that we're all going to be able to move on with this and continue our lives, I hope very soon. But of course, I don't know that. But Shane is an incredible person, and you saw a little bit about him in this documentary. I met him in 2001. We both were protesting the planned attack on Afghanistan and then Iraq as a reaction to 9/11. We were part of one of the first times I think I remember meeting him was an action in Oakland to shut down the port because they were going to send military supplies. They were sending military supplies to Afghanistan, and we were dodging rubber bullets. And we were out there, you know, together. And I kind of followed Shane's work. I think a lot of people followed Shane's work over the years because he does such incredible work. And he, shortly after 2001, he went to the Middle East and he started to study Arabic. He's now a phenomenal, fluent Arabic speaker. And so I was kind of following his movements, keeping on his email list, seeing what he's doing. And I remember I would just get an email every once in a while and think, that guy, that incredible guy, he's in Yemen now, you know? Like, I want to go to Yemen. And we came back from Yemen and we started to get to know each other. We became really close friends, and I kind of found out that he'd been following me too over the years, the work that I was doing, the international solidarity work and such. So we, Shane and I fell in love, and really falling in love with Shane, a part of falling in love with him was falling in love with his work and with his with the Middle East through him. He, as you saw quickly in the film, Shane was 18 the first time that he went to the Middle East, and there was really like no looking back for him. He was so stunned and completely transformed by it. He said, I want to be a part of showing people the beautiful side of this region. And so as you know, as we, as our relationship developed really quickly, we decided that we wanted to go to the Middle East and live in the Middle East together. And we started to save up money, and I got a job eventually teaching English to Iraqi refugees in Damascus. And in 2008, we went to the Middle East. I spent the best year of my life there, and obviously I also spent the most horrible nightmare of my life there. And it's still going on. It hasn't changed how I feel about the Middle East. It hasn't changed about how I feel about justice and about how important international solidarity work is. And I know that it hasn't changed how Shane feels about it. It's going to make him more passionate and more determined to do what he does. And it just can't happen too soon. So. Well, I just want to take this opportunity to kind of tell you, since this is Shane's second birthday present, he turns 29 today, and I'm sure that Josh's most incredible friend you could ever imagine. If there are two people that I would choose to go through the most horrible experience of my life with, I would choose these two incredible young men. They're both selfless and giving and beautiful. No matter how tense and horrible things got, we never turned on each other. We always treated each other with the utmost respect and dignity. And I know that Josh and Shane are still doing that now. I know that today Josh is doing something special for Shane's birthday. We always came up with something to mark these days, no matter how painful they were. And I just, you know, the personal side of Shane, so many of you know Shane here, but a lot of you don't. And he's the kind of person that gets so much joy and energy from other people that he would be the last person in the world that would want anyone else's light to dim. You know, he celebrates whatever other people have to give, and he sort of approaches every person equally and treats everyone with incredible magnanimity and generosity. He's incredibly ambitious, and he's actually had that effect on me and on a lot of people who he's touched, because he just doesn't he was actually a peace and conflict studies major at UC Berkeley, and he wasn't in photography or journalism, but he just sort of made his way into those classes because his work was so good, and they accepted him. And he's ambitious, but he's the least egotistical person that I've ever met. He puts himself out there because he's doing it out of a deep passion and love for life and people, and a deep love for justice. So it's very ironic that Shane is where he's at now. And there's so many levels of irony to our story. One is just that I've never met anyone that loves the Middle East as much as Shane does. And another is, that this is one of the arguably biggest cases of foreign nationals being detained the longest in Iran, in the Islamic Republic of Iran. And it's three peace activists that got caught in a really bad place at a really bad time.